52-year-old woman with a history of hypertension and type 2 diabetes presents to the ER, complaining of chest pain for the past hour, radiating into her jaw. She complains of shortness of breath. The patient is placed on a cardiac monitor. Evaluation: skin, clammy and diaphoretic, CV, regular rate and rhythm, without audible murmurs, rub or gallop. Respiratory: lungs are clear bilaterally with equal breath sounds. RR is 16 with breathing slightly labored. CNS, alert and oriented times 4, but appears uncomfortable and anxious. Identify the rhythm. A. B. C. D. Correct answer: B. NSR with PVCs. PVCs are early with wide, bizarre QRS and no discernible P waves. Your immediate intervention is A, B, C, D. Correct answer: A. Obtain a 12-lead EKG to determine if there is underlying ischemia. While you are starting the IV, the patient vomits and loses consciousness. The monitor reveals this rhythm. You should A, B, C, D. Correct answer: D. Begin CPR. As soon as you recognize cardiac arrest, you should begin high-quality CPR. You identified that this is a shockable rhythm, so a team member should prepare to defibrillate. Although immediate defibrillation is the priority, CPR should not be delayed while preparations are made to shock. After shocking the patient, you should next A, B, C, D. Correct answer: B. Continue CPR. After any defibrillation, the next step is to resume high-quality CPR. After CPR, the monitor continues to show VFib. What is your next intervention? A. B. C. D. Correct answer: D. Defibrillate. Ventricular fibrillation is a shockable rhythm, so the next appropriate intervention is to defibrillate. Your next consideration, in light of the continuing VFib on the monitor, should now be A, B, C, D. Correct answer: C. Epinephrine, 1 milligram IV. If a shockable rhythm continues after high-quality CPR and 2 defibrillations, the team should administer epinephrine. You give 1 milligram epinephrine IV. How often can you repeat this dose? A.
B. C. D.
Correct answer A. Every 3 to 5 minutes. There is no dosing limit for epinephrine. After giving the epinephrine, you see this rhythm on the monitor. What is your next intervention?
A. B. C. D.
Correct answer, A. Continue CPR. After administration of a medication, high-quality CPR is necessary to circulate the medication. After completing administration of epinephrine and the 5 cycles of CPR, the patient remains pulseless but now has the following rhythm. What is your next intervention?
A. B. C. D.
Correct answer, C. Defibrillate. You should recognize this rhythm as pulseless ventricular tachycardia, another of the shockable rhythms. You defibrillate and begin high-quality CPR. The next intervention should be
A. B. C. D.
Correct answer, C. Consider amiodarone or lidocaine. At this point, you should consider a dose of amiodarone or lidocaine IV or IO. You have given 1 dose of amiodarone. You are ready to give another dose.
1.
What is the correct dosage?
A. B. C. D.
Correct answer, B, 150 milligrams. The appropriate second dose of amiodarone is 150 milligram IV or IO. After repeating amiodarone and completing 5 cycles of CPR, you see the following rhythm. Your next intervention is
A, B, C, D.
Correct answer, C. Resume high-quality CPR. A systole is not a shockable rhythm. Instead, the team must resume high-quality CPR. The patient has a return of spontaneous circulation with a blood pressure of 90 over 60 and no spontaneous breathing. The patient is hooked to the ventilator. The rhythm strip reveals. What is your next intervention?
A. B. C. D.
Correct answer, A.